Hello viewers, I am Dr. Narottam Agarwala. Today, I am going to tell you about vitamin D. Apart from this vitamin, rest of the vitamins are consumed as a part of our diet. But this vitamin is actually manufactured inside our body. Actually, vitamin D can be called as a hormone, but since some of its properties match as vitamins, so it is called a vitamin. Commonly, vitamins are of two types, fat-soluble and water-soluble. Vitamins which can dissolve in water are called water-soluble vitamins. Vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin. It cannot dissolve in water. It can dissolve in fat. Vitamin D is of two types, vitamin D2 and vitamin D3. The vitamin which is generated in our body with the help of sunlight is vitamin D3, and it is essential for us. It is synthesized when UVB rays from the sun strike our skin. After being manufactured, this vitamin is activated in liver and kidney and regulates more than 200 genes in our body, which includes brain, heart, kidney, bone, intestine, skin, gonads, prostate, breast, parathyroid, and immune system. You must have commonly heard that vitamin D is essential for our bone health. This is because vitamin D helps to maintain the level of calcium and phosphorus in the bloodstream. And you know, calcium and phosphorus are essential for bones. Vitamin D is capable to both activate and suppress the immune system. Sometimes it suppresses our immune system, as we can notice in rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, or in multiple sclerosis. Many a times vitamin D activates our immune system to fight with certain diseases like cancer, tuberculosis, pneumonia, flu. Vitamin D reduces the risk of heart attack. Not only this, it also reduces the risk of stroke. I have seen it many a times in my practice that it helps a lot in diabetes. In diabetes, it improves the release and response of insulin. Now you might be wondering that when the sunlight can produce this vitamin in the body, then how does this vitamin go low in our body? In order to understand this, we must first know how much vitamin D do our body need every day. Roughly, we need 10,000 international units of vitamin D per day. Now, in order to manufacture 10,000 international units of vitamin D, our body needs UV index 3 rays or greater than index 3 rays. The duration of sun exposure needed to manufacture this amount of vitamin D depends on the skin type and the geographic location of the place. But we do not have a lot of control over these parameters. So what can we do? We can alternatively take vitamin D from a different source, like fish oil and cod liver oil. Let us now understand an easy calculation. Due to clothes, only 50 to 75% of our skin can be exposed to sunlight, and sunlight contains UV index 3 or higher rays between morning 10:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. afternoon. Early in the morning before 10:30 a.m. and evening, we find more UVA rays in the sunlight. UVA has no role in manufacturing vitamin D in our body. Actually, UVA harms our skin. Now let's know the reasons for vitamin D deficiency in human body. The first reason is UV exposure. If we are exposed to less amount of UVB rays, then our body will not be able to manufacture sufficient quantity of vitamin D. Sunscreen with SPF 15 do not allow UV rays to penetrate our skin. So our body is not able to manufacture sufficient vitamin D. Now, if our body is manufacturing less amount of vitamin D and we are not consuming vitamin D supplements, then we may have vitamin D deficiency. There are certain liver and kidney diseases wherein, although we have sufficient quantity of vitamin D in our body, still this vitamin D is not able to get activated and we get symptoms of vitamin D deficiency. Another reason is obesity. Obesity also reduces the level of vitamin D in our body, since vitamin D is fat soluble and obese people have a lot of fat in their body. This fat keeps holding the vitamin D. Another reason is old age. In old age, our body is able to manufacture less amount of vitamin D. But this does not mean that those people who are older, they need to expose more to the sun. Vitamin D is associated with many diseases like muscular pain called myalgia, cancer, diabetes, high blood pressure, congestive heart failure, diseases related to bones like rickets, osteomalacia, osteoporosis, autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, multiple sclerosis, lupus, and depression. After listening to so big diseases, everyone will feel that we should consume vitamin D. But excess amount of vitamin D is toxic for our body. But the good thing is that even excessive exposure to sun rays do not produce toxicity. But it has its own risk, like skin cancer, sun tanning, etc. So you might be wondering if we can take this light from artificial source. But this is not free from side effects. Since some of the artificial lights have UVA, UVB and UVC, all the three rays. UVA tans our skin very quickly. UVC, which is actually stopped by the ozone layer in our atmosphere, it is very harmful. So we need only UVB for vitamin D synthesis. Most of the UV bulbs have excessive amount of UVA rays, which causes skin tanning and the risk of skin cancer increases. Vitamin D helps in absorption of calcium. When the level of vitamin D in our body reduces, then the parathormone stimulates the breakdown of bones so that we have sufficient amount of calcium in our bloodstream. But it is very harmful for our bones. Whatever supplement we might take, but the best is sunlight. So we should try to expose ourselves to sunlight between 10:30 a.m. and 2 p.m. for a sufficient duration, 2 to 3 times a week. Remember to subscribe for more videos.